can still go, alhamdulillah, to our homes. وأنتم تسكنون في هذه البيوت الحديثة المزودة بكل وسائل الراحة من الإنارة والتكييف الصيفي والشتوي والمياه المتدفقة العذبة الحارة الباردة. سبحان الله. Now remember those who don't have no homes, the homeless, and also the people going through some hardship. Somebody who they like the refugees right now, meaning in Syria, in Somalia, in Yemen, in many countries, Iraq, they going through a lot of hardship. May Allah make things easy for them. I mean, he says, but you, subhanAllah, you go home, modern home, equipped with all of the means of luxury and ease, and we have light, subhanAllah. You turn, that's a switch. You flick the switch, you got light. You got air conditioning in the summer. Right or wrong? It's 95 degrees out there. You go home, it's 70. Some even sit it on 55. Okay? Now in the winter when it's freezing cold, and it's 33 degrees, that's what freezing cold in Georgia. But up north, freezing cold is minus 15, minus 20. That's what it is. So now when it's very cold and you can even stand outside and you go home, well, what's in your home? The heat. If you pay the bills, of course. You got heat now. SubhanAllah, you get in from like minus 10 to what? To 89 degrees. Allahu Akbar. You think yourself, you live in Philly, but you go home, you think yourself you're in Miami, in Florida. That's how it feels. Alhamdulillah, you got the heat. You got water. Not the water that comes only half an hour in the morning, like in some places, some people, that's how it is. They have faucets, but they tell them, look, water is going to be from 6:15 in the morning until 6:45. If somebody oversleep, what happened? They have no water for that day. I remember I was in one of those countries, and that's what they did. Well, they have it twice. Half an hour in the morning, half an hour in the evening. Because I remember when I just got there, and they put me in this place with some people, we share a room. And I'm like, they have a lot of gallons of water under the bed, around the bed. I'm like, why you guys have all these gallons of water? They said, you will know at 5:30. I'm like, what do you mean 5:30? They said, you will know. And it was like 3 something. I'm like, well, I'm going to go take a shower. They said, yeah, okay. 5:30. I said, no, I want to do it now. They're like, brother, 5:30. I went, no water. No water. Faucet, all of them, no water. I said, hey, guys, no water. They said, we told you. So that's why we have these things. So that's it. But we go home, turn the faucet. Some even turn the faucet. Wasting water is on the phone. Yeah, alhamdulillah, inshallah. Water is running. People don't have that. No, you have to turn, don't be extravagant. Thank Allah for that ni'mah. Don't take it for granted. Shaykh said, you have water. Not only any water, you have, subhanAllah, you have what? Fresh water. Like you can drink it. And you have hot and cold water. Not just cold water. You even have hot water in our homes. Some other people, they have to heat up the water, right or wrong? I've done it many times when I was young. When I was young in our home, well, alhamdulillah, it's a nice home, but we didn't have water in the home. We have a well. And that well, it was like 300 feet away from the house. And you have to go and get it with the, what do you call it? Bucket. With the bucket, yeah. And then you have to set your own fire. We didn't even have no gas stove, nothing. You have to make the fire first, let it catch up, then go get the water and put it on the fire to heat up. It takes like half an hour, talking about taking a shower in 2 minutes. Teach you patience and gratitude. Half an hour, 40 minutes for that water to heat up. And that's all you have. That bucket, you take it with you to the bathroom, right? And that's all you have, man. I remember me, sometimes I don't manage, no more water, I still have shampoo on my head. You have two things, whether just do that like that, or you have to wait, sit right there until my mother or somebody in my family do the same thing, go to the well and put some water and wait for 40 minutes. Sometimes if it's cold in the winter, they give you a blanket. You wrap it until the water is ready, but now we go there and we complain. Water, subhanAllah, you turn, one turn, not even 3 seconds, hot water comes in. You can't even take a shower, you have to mix it with cold water. And what you do at that time? Remember the ni'mah of Allah. There are people who don't have these things. Remember the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Shaykh said all of this from the ni'mah of Allah in these homes, which require from us to give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Don't take it for granted, man, because he says there are people used to live in luxury in Syria, in Yemen, in Iraq, in Libya, and they're going through hardship now. They couldn't even find water to drink. They don't care what color this water is, mixed with mud or mixed with I don't know what. They can't even find water. But me and you, we go home now, we turn water, we have water everywhere, in the kitchen, 3-4 bathrooms loaded with water. We have mineral water, purified water, drinking water, spring water, all of these things. Gotta thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال الشيخ حفظه الله لأن ذلك منا وفضل من الله, because all of this we have these homes and they are equipped with all of this modern technology and this water, hot water, heat, air conditioning, all that is from Allah. It's a ni'mah, a favor, a gift, a kind act from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala towards his servants. ثم قال الشيخ عباد الله إن بيت المسلم يجب أن يكون متميزا عن غيره من البيوت. Now he says, after this introduction, the Shaykh says, حفظ الله الشيخ صالح الفوزان, the Muslim home or house got to be and it should be distinguished from other than it than the homes. Aynam, that home in that block, you may be the only Muslim, like for us, we live in the West, your home supposed to be distinguished, not like other homes. How is that? Can somebody give me an idea? How is that? The paint, for example? No. The little one. Ibnuka? Ismuhu? Abdullah. Naam, Abdullah. No Christmas trees. No Christmas trees. No, Hassan. No.
Should be clean.
No cameras of fighting. No.
No TV.
No TV. Tayyib.
It's a place where Allah is to be remembered.
No. Hassan. No. Abdul Rahman. Hassan. No. جزاكم الله خيرا. The Sheikh says how the Muslim home should be distinct from other homes, shouldn't resemble the other rest of other homes. بفعل ما شرعه الله للمسلمين في بيوتهم. How are you going to make your home outstand, then make the exception? It's not by having a bigger yard. The paint, none of that. By performing that which Allah has legislated for the Muslims in their homes. That's how the home will be different. And what is that Allah has legislated for the Muslims? Dhikr Allah, the remembrance of Allah. وَالْإِكْثَارُ مِنْ صَلَاتِ النَّوَافِلِ فِيهَا, for men to perform the supererogatory prayers the Nawafil prayers a lot in these homes, the recitation of the Quran in these homes. That's how it's going to be a Muslim home. Not just like we say yesterday, just buy a 99 cents logo, this is a Muslim home, and put it outside on the door, on the front door, this is a Muslim home. And then once the person go beyond that, what is Islam? What is the practice of Islam? What is Quran? What is the remembrance of Allah? This is how a Muslim home is a Muslim home. When the people that live in it, they adhere to the legislation of Allah. They fulfill what Allah has made obligatory upon them. They are obedient to Allah. The Shaykh mentioned examples, dhikrullah, a lot of remembrance of Allah. The men, they pray the separatory prayers as to the best of their abilities in there. Tahajjud, duha, and the like. And the recitation of the Quran, ma'a khuluwiha min wasa'il fasad. By doing, while doing these good acts, then those home has to be free from all means of corruption. Don't mix the good and the bad. Quran in the morning, disco in the evening. Okay, this is a Muslim home. Wow, you gotta be balanced. This is how you think balance is. Read Quran in the morning and music in the afternoon? Huh? Halaqa in the morning and I don't know what in the evening? Nah. Have to be free from the means of corruption and fasad and evil. Then the Shaykh began to give some of the narration that will help us to understand this matter. عن أبي موسى رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم on the authority of أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله عنه said that the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said مثل البيت الذي يذكر الله فيه والبيت الذي لا يذكر الله فيه مثل الحي والميت. The example of the house in which Allah is remembered, the people there, they remember Allah. And the home that Allah is not remembered is like the one who is alive and the one who is dead. It's like the living and the dead, subhanAllah. هل يستويان? Are they equal, the one who is alive and the one who is dead? Of course they are not. وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال And on the authority of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اجعلوا من صلاتكم في بيوتكم ولا تتخذوها قبورا. Make some of your prayers in your homes. Perform, Allah is addressing here the men. Perform prayers at home. And we're going to understand, the Shaykh is going to explain what it means. Okay, prayer home for men. Pray at home and don't make your homes like graveyards. Like graveyards. قال الشيخ صالح الفوزان أي صلوا فيها من النوافل ولا تجعلوها كالقبور مهجورة من الصلاة. Said meaning, what means this hadith? For men to perform the supererogatory prayer, the sunnah prayer, the nawafil prayer, not the obligatory prayer, the sunnah prayer, the nawafil in your home. And don't make it like the graves, because you cannot pray in the graves. It's not permissible to pray just to pray at the graves. وعن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال. He mentioned a third narration now on the authority of أبي هريرة, عبد الرحمن بن صخر الدوسي رضي الله عنه. قال إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال. He said, the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said. And when you hear a companion says, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, we have to pay attention. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was sent by Allah to teach us good. فَهُوَ مُعَلِّمُ النَّاسِ الْخَيْرِ. Whenever you hear a companion says, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, we Muslims, we have to pay attention. Because what we're going to hear, about to hear, is good for us. Whether something that we should do or something we should stay away from. Guidelines from the Messenger of Allah, guidance from Him. And they can never be better than that.